Hi all, this second tutorial was going to take you through using VoiceThread, and this should be pretty quick, hopefully, since the last one was super long, so we'll see. This isn't the deck that we made in the previous tutorial, but it's pretty similar. The only thing that's different here, well, the colors are a little different, and there's this piece here where I've got these shapes that I gave fuzzy edges to in order to these soft edges in order to differentiate the copy from the image in the background, but it's still a pretty clumsy way to do it. I don't usually suggest that, which is why I eliminated it. But okay, so for VoiceThread, the first thing you need to do, and you need to do this, please do not upload your PowerPoint directly to VoiceThread. The first thing you need to do is to save this as a PDF. And don't print as a PDF, save as a PDF. Here I've got my branded PowerPoint sample PDF, and I'm going to save it to my desktop. And the reason you do this is that when you upload to VoiceThread, it will often lose this material. And so you want to be very careful about that. The soft edges will disappear. Sometimes the fonts will change. There's all sorts of stuff that can happen. So never upload your PowerPoint directly. One thing that is important to mention is that things like the transitions and animations that might be on some of your slides, those are going to disappear. So transitions and animations do not work in VoiceThread, which makes things a lot easier in some ways, but it also makes things a lot less seamless, and it means you tend to have to put either more on a slide or really work to have multiple slides with very similar content that you can build step by step so you don't overwhelm people with a lot of copy. Okay, let's go to VoiceThread. So from I've chosen a private browser here, but it doesn't really matter. I'm just doing this so that I'm not already logged in. Go to odu.voicethread.com. And obviously, this is for students at Old Dominion University. Otherwise, you would just go to voicethread.com. So you put in your username and password. And in our case, of course, it's going to send me the little push, the two-step authentication. Once that's approved, it's going to take you to VoiceThread itself. And so you can see a few of the VoiceThreads that students have done, or here's the one for module one. And you want to click on create. And then from add media, I'm just going to drag in the branded VoiceThread. So I'm going to enter in a title. So this is just VoiceThread sample. And that's it. In playback options, make sure that you enable threaded commenting, and that's really important. Just make sure that you do that. If you are working with other people, you might want to allow commenters to add slides. So if you're doing this as a team, you can choose to allow people to download media like images, to export, whatever. Usually I leave on start playing when opened and enable threaded commenting, and that's basically it. In allowed comment methods, I do microphone, webcam, and text. I do not do telephone or file upload. It just gets a little crazy. And I tend to eliminate these things as well, although you can actually record yourself going through an entire deck, but I don't suggest that you do that. So I'm just going to leave that alone. And then click on save. And then here we've got the VoiceThread. So these are all the slides. Notice that they look different, but don't worry about that. It's not it doesn't actually look different. You can delete these if you have put in some kind of image. So let's say I've got this slide here. I can let's say I've made a misspelling or something. I can actually go through and take just one slide from the PowerPoint deck, export that slide. And then I can replace it here, or I can simply add the new slide and then delete it and move it around. If you click and move these, you can choose where you want them to go, which is really useful. Another thing that you might want to do is also be able to add media. afterwards, so other slides, but in this case, I might want to add like a video. So let's say I want to add something like a YouTube video from the Norfolk Botanical Garden. I can do that. And so let's see what comes up. So here we have somebody that's traveling. So these are not from their actual stuff, an orientation program, Norfolk TV. So there's a lot of stuff about the gardens here, but I'm not seeing anything from the gardens themselves. And so, you know, that's a problem, of course, for the brand. But let's say I wanted to bring one of these in to highlight, let's say, the Million Bulb Walk. So if I grab that, so I'm not going to actually go through. It's pretty annoying. I'm not going to worry about the content here. This is also really long, so let me go back to another one that might be a little shorter. Let's say this one is only 2 minutes long. So one of the things that you can do from VoiceThread, I'm going to copy this and I can paste it in. So I can add media and I'm going to do media sources. And I'm sorry, that's not what I wanted to do. I wanted to do URL. And this might work, but it often doesn't work. So I'm going to let that process while I show you the other way to do this. The way to do that is to actually grab a YouTube video from someplace else. So what I normally do is Google download YouTube video and then find one. So there's save the video, y2mate.guru. You know, just choose whichever one. Sometimes they work, sometimes they don't work. And then you want to paste that same URL in here. And so what I want to do is download this video, right? I'm not really sure what's going on here, but usually it's just this first one. And it's probably going to bring up an ad. Yep. And hopefully it will bring up some options in a second for actually downloading. Usually these are full of ads, and so I don't want to, so you can see there's an error here. So that might not work. Oh, here we go. That did work. Here we go. Okay. So it brought it up, and I want to do it in MP4, and this one is in high res. Usually it will give you a variety of resolutions here. And so we want to go ahead and download this as 4K, although it might not let us do it. Okay, so best quality of MP4 is the 720. This is probably going to send us to an ad, I'm guessing. Yeah, it is. Okay. So I'm just going to click on the video. And I'm not sure why it did this, but you can go ahead and right click and do save video as from here. The other website does it a little differently, but I'm just going to go ahead and save the video as desktop video playback. That's fine. This website, Y2Mate, does it a little differently, but again, it's full of ads. So just choose whichever one seems to work for you and go from there. Okay, so here it looks like it's processed. Let's see if it works, but I'm going to go ahead and add the video just so you can see. So my computer, and then I'm going to grab that. It was called video playback. Open. So this is going to take a little while to upload the video. I'm going to pause it just to make it run a little faster. Okay, so it has uploaded through the magic of video editing. And so here it's going to process again. So let's see if this one works first. But I'll show you how to comment and then we can go through from there. So I'm going to go to step two, which is comment. And you'll see it brings up the PowerPoint. It looks good. That's exactly what we want. And then what you do is click on this little button down here, and it's going to give you three options because I only allowed those three. One is video, one is audio, and one is text. So in this case, I will not do a video or an audio just because, well, I can show you how it looks. It's going to ask you which microphone and everything, just because it's going to make a little weird thing. So it's got me here in my hoodie because it's cold right now. And so it is now recording my video. So I can stop recording. Notice that there was a little pen there in the bottom right-hand corner. And that would allow you to actually go through and like circle or write on little bits of an image as you're going, which can be really nice if you're pointing out maybe something that works and something that doesn't work with your
My hoodie
like
because
a
it's
website
cold
image.
right now.
So I'm gonna go ahead and save that video. And here's the comment. And once this comment opens, you can customize this too with various things, but you can trash it. You can put in closed captioning for accessibility, and then you can respond to this. So this is what you'll do when you're responding to each other or responding to me and asking questions and things like that. You'll click here, and then it creates this little bubble underneath. And I don't know why that disappeared. Here we go. So once we've got that bubble, again, we can make something that's threaded even to that. And this can be a really nice way to do
My
things,
hoodie
right?
because it's
So there we go. So I can go ahead and make these other comments. So this is a really nice feature with VoiceThread. It allows you to make some really, really cool changes here and without having a whole bunch of chaos. So you have comments, but comments commenting on comments rather than just individual pieces randomly pointing out different things. So then you go to the next slide and you go ahead and make your comments here. So this is how you go through. You just make a comment on each slide when you're making your own, or of course you can always respond to or comment on something I or somebody else has said. So now I'm going to go to the end here where it's got that URL. And here it seems like this is adding a from YouTube. And it did. And that is sometimes that works and sometimes it doesn't. So just be aware that that can happen. And then we're going to go to the next slide. And this is the one that I uploaded and it also works. So that's basically it, except I want to show you the last little bit here. So when I'm in edit, the last step is to share. And here what you can do is you can choose our class. So you can do it that way. And the other thing to do, and that's a fine way to do it, but the other way to do it is to get a link and make sure that you allow anybody who has the link to view and to comment. And then you want to copy this link, Control C, done. And then you can email that to people, or in our case, you can put it on the discussion board post on Blackboard so that we can access it from there and have it all organized rather than have everybody share everything with everybody else. But go ahead and share it with the group, with the class, and then still post it to Blackboard. And that's it. Thanks, guys.